minor deadlock over the admission of 16 nations to the United Nations ends. The Council President, Sir Leslie Monroe, hears the arguments of United States Ambassador Lodge on behalf of the free nations. Prior to the voting, the Russian delegate, Arkady Sobolev, names the nations agreed upon in the compromise. Of the 16, 12 belong to the group of free nations and 4 to the communist bloc. The suddenness with which the decision was reached prevented 5 of the nations nominated from getting delegates to the scene on time to be seated immediately. Others, representing 11 nations, are welcome to the world body, which now numbers 76 members. An Air Force base, the nose section of a Convair supersonic jet fighter is mounted on a rocket sled, its pilot an instrument-laden dummy, for a new series of supersonic bailout tests. Ultra-slow-motion cameras film events at over 700 miles an hour as the dummy is ejected and hit by an airstream of battering ram force, a force that has hospitalized for 9 months the only man ever to make a supersonic bailout. Man can barely survive such crippling stresses. These tests are aimed at conquering the real barrier to further progress in the air, the barrier of human frailty. The long-awaited